Sometimes we'd go to bed and it'd be getting light outside. We'd literally see that the birds would start and it'd be getting light. So it was late night sometime. Hi, it's Eve and I'm here with Closer Online and I'm going to be spilling the tea on my Love Island experience. I was approached through an email. Me and my sister both got the same email. Then we had a phone call. Then we went in and met the producers. And yeah, this all started from there. I guess like, I went on for love. Like, I did want to find like a boyfriend. I think me and Jess were both like, wow, like this would be a good place to find boyfriends. But then obviously there is like all the opportunities that come with it. But I feel like that's definitely a bonus. Like you do go on there for love. Like if you don't want to find love, then there's no point you going on. 100%, like I genuinely, well, I'd like to think so. Like I just can't wait for them all to get out. Like now Leanne's out, I can't wait to see her. And I feel like us girls, like when we were in the villa, all we spoke about was what we were gonna do when we get out. So yeah, definitely, I hope that we'll all be really close when we get out. Like I really miss like music, I miss TV. But in there, like you are busy, like there's always stuff to do, like the challenges, recouplings, you're always getting your makeup, hair, like you're not really bored so much, and then you've got other people, so I wouldn't say it's boring. It kind of, that's what surprised me, there's always something to do in there. I wouldn't say they were overly involved, but they are definitely there like a lot of the time. Like you are making a TV show, like it's not scripted and they don't ever force you to do anything, but they're always there like if you want to talk to them about stuff. Like producers are there to kind of like guide you if you want to talk about your feelings, like you can talk to producers about that. It's just like having people there to support you kind of thing. Like you're not just left in the villa and like just left there. I was quite good. I was quite bad that I would always get changed and then I'd have my mic on the floor and I would leave it there and then put your mic on. Once me and Jess were like whispering, we were like, we weren't even whispering about anything bad. We were just under the covers whispering, just having a little chat because it was nice to have a private chat. And they're like, girls, like, what are you doing? I haven't watched it back from when I was in it because I feel like if I watch myself back, I cringe at myself. I hate watching myself. I'm like, oh my God. But I've watched it since I left and I've been watching my sister. I think she's doing really well, actually. I feel like she's actually starting to come across like really genuine and cool and nice and down to earth. Like I'm really proud of her. I feel like at the beginning, people kind of misunderstood me and my sister. She was getting a lot of hate. And now I think people are just seeing her for what she is. Like she's real, she says it how it is, but like she's supporting all the other girls. Like I watch her and I'm like, oh, I love you. No, I wouldn't say he's her type. I wouldn't say that she's ever gone for anyone like him. And I would say they're quite different. But that's not a bad thing. I feel like I'm quite harsh on him because I'm like judging him. I'm like, right, he's with my sister. Like, let's see what he's about. But he seems like a really nice boy. I feel like I want to see more of them. I haven't really seen enough of them to like make full judgments. But it's always like, you don't have to go for your type. Like sometimes it's your type hasn't worked out in the past. So it's best to go for something different. That's such a tricky one because out of the original, there was no one in there for me. So it'd have to be someone new. Maybe Luke T, who's with Shanice now. He's more kind of like my type, but I don't know. Maybe let's go with Luke T. Well, I haven't actually watched my bit back, so I don't actually know what they've shown, to be honest. I feel like I wish they maybe shown, so my family, like, oh, were you close with the girls? Like, did you have fun? And I'm like, yeah, I had so much fun. Like, I feel like maybe they didn't show as much of, like, the fun times we had, like, where we'd all just be chilling, laughing, like, the friendships in there. Like, you become really close friends with everyone, and I feel like maybe watching it, you feel like it's also dramatic and everyone hates each other and it's really, like, cold and, like, kind of, like, bitchy vibes, I'm allowed to say that. But I feel like actually like we all got along really well, like we were all best friends. Like I felt really nervous because also me and my sister were sat there for about 20 minutes before we were about to go in and waiting for kind of our entrance, and I could hear them all down at the bottom. They were all like just dancing and laughing and I was getting really nervous then because I have my sister and with her next to me I felt all right, like back up, you have support. But they were all really welcoming, all really nice, and like no one was kind of like cold and offish. So yeah, I felt at ease. you don't know when the recouplings are going to be, you don't know when the challenges are going to be. Like, you'll literally get the text and then like 15 minutes later you have to get ready and go out for a challenge. Like, it's very spontaneous in there. Yeah, it was like sometimes we'd go to bed and it'd be getting light outside. We'd literally see that the birds would start and it'd be getting light. So it was late night sometime, but obviously I don't know, that's me guessing because I didn't know the time. And then the mornings, like sometimes we'd get lions and stuff if we'd been up late, but usually we're up quite early. Rebecca has intrigued me. I feel like maybe Rebecca's quite misunderstood. I feel like I can definitely relate to her because obviously I had to go in, I had to take someone's guy. She has to do the same. And I feel like maybe she's been made out a villain. And I kind of feel for her because literally you do just have to do what you got to do in there. So I'm intrigued by her. Like, I want to see what she's actually like when we get out. Or I just want to ask my sister, like, what's she like? Next for me, to be honest, I'm just taking every day as it comes. I kind of feel like I'm on pause till my sister gets out, just because we literally do everything together. But I'm just keeping really busy, like keeping all my options open and just waiting on Jess to come back. I'm Eve, and that was me on my Love Island experience. Consider the tea spilled.